Salutations and good morrow, everyone, and welcome back to another Grounded Update video, where today I am hopping in and I'm showing you guys two different locations to go and get some super, super easy scarab shells. Now, what do you need scarab shells for? You're talking level 8 and level 9 weapons. You need these for mighty jewels, spicy jewels, salty jewels, fresh jewels, and sour jewels. You need all of these for those. So I'm going to be showing you guys some easy locations for you guys to be able to go and get a bunch of them right now. So this first one, we're actually over here at the Termite Hill, and we're going to be grabbing a backpack that's been known for a while. Now, this backpack, you do not need to go inside of the termite mound at all. You can literally run right up the side of the termite mound right over here, and with a little bit of parkour help, you just come right over here, jump off of here up onto this log Of course, the time I'm recording is the time I can't do it the first try, but that's how you do it. You get right up there, and then right inside of this backpack has 5 twinkling shells for you. So that's literally 5 gems right there for you. Nice. All right, so this next location, guys, has been added in Grounded 1.0, and this one brings a whole new way for you guys to go and do some exploring underneath the shed. Okay, so here we are right at the top of the entrance to go underneath the shed. The Undershed Lab, you need to progress through the story quite a bit in order to get to this part. But once you guys get here, you guys can follow this path to get you guys some very, very easy scarab shells. So let's go on in here. Now, on my way down here, I'm going to tell you guys a couple things that might be super helpful for you while you're doing this. One, get yourself a torch. It's very dark in here. You're going to want a torch, preferably a charcoal torch, but any torch will do. Two, you're going to want a glider. I have no glider, but I'll show you guys it is possible even without a glider. So you want to run on in here, open up the door with that hand scanner, make your way through here like you normally do whenever you're running through into the Undershed base. But when you come out here, normally what people would do is they'd take a nice hard right right over there, hop up on that pole and run that way, hop up on that pipe and make your way onto wonderful story goodness. We are not going to do that today. We are actually going to make our way down this way. Now, this is one of the most dangerous places in the yard for a couple of different reasons, guys. But the main one why this is so dangerous underneath here is because there is a bunch of black ox beetles right over there. But what is even more dangerous is if you fall down this hole that's over here. If you fall down this hole over here, you are literally going to be invaded by more orb weavers than even I can handle of even looking. So don't go down here, because if you do, you will die. But anyway, now that we've respawned, let's work our way back over here, right back out the way that we came. And this time, instead of looking down a giant pit that's probably got a sarlacc in it, instead, we're going to go this way, and we're going to make our way up to where all the scarabs are. Now, like I said, these scarabs are kind of a pain in the butt, and at one point, I'll have to now go back down and grab my backpack, but that's okay. You want to make your way down this power line that's right here, so that way you don't take fall damage. Work your way back up over here, and go to that wooden plank that's right there behind that roly-poly. This is a great place to go because there is some stuff to fight, but there's also some stuff for story back in here as well. I bet you guys didn't know that yeah, there's actually some story stuff over here. If you guys jump up in here, there's actually a research outpost, and right down in there, there's actually a data chip for you to find. But ignoring that dust mite, hop up here onto this power line that's up here. Hop over this nail because it's very annoying and just in your way. You got some lint clumps here you can grab if you so want to, but work your way on back this way, following along this. Now, I will warn you guys, this is a little bit of a jumping puzzle. There is a jump puzzle over here that's kind of a pain in the butt that we're going to be working our way through, but nonetheless, it's a jump puzzle, so you want to watch out for that one. But here we go. You want to get all the way to right here. And where this is a jump puzzle and why you should have brought a tuft with you is because it makes it way easier to get over onto this nail. You need to jump from here onto that nail. The best place I can tell you to aim is straight for the nail head. We're going to see if I can do it first try. Nope, I totally missed. You guys know what they say. Second time is the charm. Victory. Okay, now once you're on it, what you want to do is you want to jump from here over to here. And now that you're here, you are actually in another great spot. Now, you could jump from here down onto the quarter that's right down there, which I'm probably going to end up doing. But if you want to be a little bit safer, you can jump on top of this pipe and work your way down there. Now, if you get on top of this pipe, you can actually run down over this way. You got some raw science over there that you can grab. And you can actually follow this all the way over there to where you can get down a little bit easier for the story. But that's not what we're after today. We're actually on our way over to find scarab beetles. Yeah, not a backpack. Actually, just scarab beetles themselves. So I'm just going to drop on down right here on top of this 1988 quarter, and we're going to work our way back here, and you guys are going to start seeing their shiny little bodies right at the end of the tube. Now, why is it so easy for you guys to come in here, and why am I making a video about this? Because the scarab beetles can only go so far before they can't go any further. They can run and run and run all they like, but they can't actually dig underground inside of this PVC pipe. So you just have to be able to hit them a couple times, and nonetheless, you will be able to wipe them out and get yourself some scarab beetle shells. So it's not actually that hard. There you go. There goes two more twinkling shells. Grab a couple more here by killing these ones, and you have up to four inside of this pipe at any time. So there goes five twinkling shells. We've already got more than the backpack, and if we work our way all the way down here, trying our best not to fall down this hole and fight this scarab beetle that's right here. He's very tricky. Oh, he got away. Go get him! Get him, Pete! Get him! And just like that, the final scarab is dead. So, not only did I go ahead and get the five that I had in the backpack, I just got an additional nine of them by coming down this tube. Now, scarabs do respawn, so it's going to take a few in-game days, but you guys can come back and do this over and over and over you want. And the best part about this is even if this is your guys' first time over into the undershed area, you can actually come right over here and drop down this right here into this water and still make your way on to the next part of the story. So it's a fantastic place for you guys to come do a little bit of exploring, get a little bit of stuff, and get yourself ready for some higher tier upgrades. Be careful of all the bugs that are around here, guys. Be careful of falling in the Sarlacc pit. And as always, I'll see all of you guys in the next one.